Hey, welcome back to the Mr. Excel Netcast. I'm Bill Jelen.
Basically, you start out with massive amounts of data. Say, how are we going to analyze this? Well, let's fire up a pivot table and see if we can solve this problem.
Learn Excel from Mr. Excel Podcast, episode 2342. Can I guess your age in Excel using Wolfram Alpha Music Axe? Hey, welcome back to the Mr. Excel Netcast. I'm Bill Jelen, rocking the Springsteen on Broadway shirt for this episode. Yesterday, Wolfram Alpha Data Types in Excel first look. After I recorded that and put it up, talking to Mary Ellen, Mrs. Excel, I said, it's like Christmas getting all this new stuff. I explained to her what it does, and she came up with dozens of ideas of things we could do. All right, so I sent out a survey saying, I need some data for an Excel video. Who are your top five music acts? And actually, I just started right here in the house. We have three generations of Jelens. My son, Zeke, who used to edit the videos. My dad, a World War II veteran. And then I sent it out to a few Excel MVPs who were able to respond and some people around the office. All right. So for everyone, we have their top five. And of course, my top number one, Bruce Springsteen and the E Street Band. Now, what we're doing here is we're going to data types, and these brand new data types, they support music acts, but it's not in the list, so this is one where we're just going to use automatic. And I have to tell you, this was harder than I thought it should be. Like right here, Bruce Springsteen and the E Street Band, nothing came up, so I searched for Bruce Springsteen, and there's Bruce Springsteen, a person. That's not what I wanted. I wanted the musical act, right? And to make sure that was working, I came out here and said equal B2 dot language entity type. And I had to check all these because lots of times I got the person instead of the music act. They say at Microsoft, if I would have searched for Bruce Springsteen music act, that I would have had better luck. I'll have to try that at some point. All right, so step one, all 55 bands or a couple that were repeated, I've now successfully got them to be listed as a music act. Right here, there are 55 rows, 11 different names. So I use the new unique. That's not new anymore. The unique function to pull the list of names here. And then a simple little index number one and index of H2 hashtag, which gives us that whole range. If I would add someone else, that would work, and I want the first person. All right, now to get my list of five, this is awesome if this works. I used the filter function to get the list of five, which gave me five cells going down, ran that into the transpose. But what I love about this is that it gave me not just the name of the band, but the actual data type cell as well. So all the data in the data type cell came over as the result of this formula, which is wild. Now you look at this and say, okay, this is just one cell. How much is really there? How much is there? It's crazy how much is there. So down here, I say equal K2 dot works, like what songs have they created? And my love will not let you down. Prove it all night. Two hearts, Atlantic City. You're lucky I'm not going to sing any of these to you, but I'm going to press control down arrow and it goes down to row 535. I think earlier when I tried it, in yesterday's video, you didn't see that page, but I had just Bruce Springsteen music act, and there were over 1,000 songs that came up. Now, for each of these songs, remember it cascades. So now I'm in K5, and over here I say equal K5 hash dot first release date, and it tells me the date that the song was released. All right, so for each person here, I can get a list of all their songs and when that song came out. Now, I'm going to try and combine those two columns, right? So let's take a look at these two formulas. Equal K2.works and then equal K5.firstReleaseDate here in step two. Check this out. This is just awesome that this is working. When I come here, equal L2.works.firstReleaseDate and it brings me a list of all of the release dates of those songs. I'm not seeing the song titles anymore, but that's okay. I know that's working from the previous cell. And there was one, it's really weird. Mary Ellen had Jimmy Buffett as her one of her top five, and out of the 350 songs, there was one that came back with a field error. How can they not know when it was released if they know that it's a song? But okay, I'll take that. So I had to wrap the whole thing in if error to get this to work. All right, now follow along. I now have a list of all of the songs when the Eagles released. Randy Austin, the newest Excel MVP. Hey, Randy, thanks for sending in your list. And what I did, I said, all right, these dates, think about a typical rock band. They start out with a couple of albums that are kind of obscure, and then maybe around the third album, they really hit it big. Bruce Springsteen, it was Born to Run in 75 that he really became famous. Two albums before that, not so much, right? So I said, I'm going to take all of these dates here. I'm not going to average them. Instead, I'm going to ask for what's at the second quartile, so 40% of the way through, right? And that got me a series of dates. And then I took the five favorite bands, and I averaged those and converted it to a year, the year of the average. All right, now, unfortunately, the annoying thing here is I had to type in each person and get their score over here. There's the year. And, you know, it's kind of funny. When I look at this data, it tends to, I don't know a lot of these people's age, but it tends to kind of be like somewhere between high school and college that year, at least for the people who I know what year they were born. Not always, but just seems to work out. I actually tried data, what if analysis, data table, and while you would think there's no chance that would work, it actually very slowly started crunching through, but we were getting some errors because, I don't know, maybe it was timing out or the hash busy error or something was causing it to not work. Kudos for even trying it, but I realized that just wasn't it. Probably should have knocked out some VBA to type in a value here and then record the score there. But anyway, here are the 11 scores, right? And then down here, I sorted that data, these scores up here, by the second column in ascending order, right? So there's my dad, 98, at the beginning of the list, and my son, in his 20s, at the bottom of the list. And when I look at this, you know, again, I don't know everyone's age, but it really seems that they are almost in the correct order. Might be one or two that are out of order, but for the most part, pretty crazy to take all of this data just based on your five favorite musical acts, and it kind of gets you into the correct sequence. Just so you can see how it's working, let's change from Randy Austin to Mike Gervin, H4. And we get five different bands. For each of those bands, we get a whole series of dates that the songs were released, figure out the second quartile, and then average it, and 1987. These new, cool Wolfram Alpha data types are really amazing. And remember, there's over 100 data types. Just fabulous stuff. All right. Also, you know, I didn't bother to show the card yesterday. If you click here, you get the little card that kind of gives you some of the information that you're going to see. My complaint here is this is a little narrow. Like, so works. It, you know, my love will not let you but in fact, there's over 500 there. So the card, I think, is becoming really much too small for how much data we're getting. And plus, each of those songs then leads to a release date and on and on and on and on and on and on. All right. Please, down below the video, click like, subscribe, maybe ring that bell. Feel free to post any questions or comments down in the comments below. My new book, Mr. Excel 2020, Seeing Excel Clearly. Click that I in the top right-hand corner for more information. I want to thank you for stopping by. We'll see you next time for another netcast from Mr. Excel. Tips and tricks, get your spreadsheet fixed at MrExcel.com.